This is Westward Television. We're broadcasting from the transmitters of the Independent Broadcasting Authority. Today is Saturday, the 19th of September.
All the advertisements that you will see on this channel today have been cleared by the IBA and the television companies in accordance with the statutory requirements of the Independent Broadcasting Authority Act and the IBA Code of Advertising Standards and Practice.
Hello, children. Hello, everyone. Look at the clock. It says 7 o'clock. Is that the time when you get up in the morning? Perhaps you don't have to get up until 7:30, or even 8 o'clock. But what have I got here? A flannel and a toothbrush. Is that one of the first things you have to do when you get up in the morning? Wash all that sleepy dust out of your eyes. Sometimes you don't clean your teeth until after breakfast. And then you have to make sure that there's no egg left around your face. And Mum and Dad come chasing you and saying, "Have you really cleaned your teeth?" Well, sometimes children try and escape having their faces washed altogether. But I think if you didn't do the job properly, your teacher might know what you've had for breakfast. Now, in our country, we pay a great deal of attention to keeping our hands and faces clean. But in the country where Jesus lived, they paid a great deal of attention to keeping their feet clean. Now, Palestine was very hot, and the roads that they walked along weren't like our roads and pavements. They were very dusty tracks and pathways. And Jesus and his friends didn't wear shoes and socks like you do. They just wore very open sandals on their bare feet, and that meant by the end of the day, their feet were very dirty and dusty. Well, I think if you played outside without your shoes and socks on and then looked at the soles of your feet, you might discover that they turned very black and very dirty. And so the people in that country had a special custom. They used to stand a large jar of cool water just inside the doorway of the house. You see, they didn't have any taps or wash basins or baths like we have in most of our houses. So they used to put this big jar of cool water inside the doorway so that when someone came into the house, they were able to wash the dust off their hot feet. Well, wouldn't it seem strange if Mum did that for you when you came home from school? Now, sometimes Jesus talked to his friends, and one day he said to them that it wasn't just enough to be clean on the outside, but that you had to be clean inside as well. Now, that was a very strange thing to say. Imagine trying to scrub with your flannel down inside. But what Jesus was really trying to say was that it wasn't enough just to look nice and clean with nice clean faces, but that we had to be nice, kind, friendly, happy people as well. I've brought someone along to show you. Here is Amanda. Now, Amanda hasn't got egg round her face. In fact, she looks nice and clean. She's got a clean dress on as well. She could be going to a party. But I'm sorry to say that Amanda isn't as nice as she looks. Do you know what she did the other day at school? She picked up the black paintbrush and splashed it all over the other children's paintings because she thought they were better than hers. And then out in the playground, she pushed one of the smaller children down the steps and made them cry. And last night at home, she shouted at Mummy because she couldn't stay up late. Well, I don't think that's very nice, do you? I hope you wouldn't be like that. You see, Amanda isn't as nice as she looks. And so will you remember that it's not just good enough to have a nice, clean face, but that we've also got to be nice, friendly, happy people as well. There's a nice face here. someone's done a lovely face using all sorts of bits and pieces. Claire Trump has done that. And here's one that James Rees has done. I think they've used lots of wool and string and things like that. Thank you, James, for that smiling face. I wonder if you'd like to send me a picture of perhaps you cleaning your face or brushing your teeth in the morning. Actually, Gus Honeybun's looking a bit worried because he thinks I'm going to come at him with a wet flannel and a toothbrush. So we'd better watch out. Goodbye now. Goodbye. Thank you.